It's a very long passage. Three people are going to read the Bibles for us. Please be attentive. The very reading will help you. After that, I got only 100 points to share with you. God bless you.
The reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 37, verses 1 to 7. Psalms 37, verses 1 to 7. Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass, and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord, and do good. So shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord, and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. The reading shall be continued.
Psalms 34, verses 8 to 14. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. O fear the Lord, ye his saints, for there is no want to them that fear him. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. Come, ye children, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man is he that desireth life and loveth many days, that he may seek good? Keep thy tongue from evil and thy lips from speaking guile. Depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The Bible reading continues.
The reading continues from verse 15 to verse 22. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open unto their cry. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord heareth, and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all. He keepeth all his bones, not one of them is broken. Evil shall slay the wicked, and they that hate the righteous shall be desolate. The Lord redeemeth the soul of his servants, and none of them that trust in him shall be desolate. Here ends the reading.
Verse 1. I'll bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I'll bless the Lord at all times. At all times, bless the Lord. Why? In good time or bad time? At all times, the psalmist says, I will bless the Lord. Why should we bless the Lord at all times? When we read this passage carefully, at least in six places you'll see the word all. And number one, I will praise the Lord at all times. What are the all times? What are the different times he faced in his life? In the rest of the verses we read, and psalmist says that I will praise the Lord at all times, and his praise will be in my mouth continually. The background is very important. The background we read is a psalm of David when he changed his behavior before Abimelech, who drew him away and he departed. So David was acting like a mental person just to save his life before Abimelech. And Abimelech drew him away. Now David was hiding in a place called Adullam. When he was in that cave, just imagine a champion who killed Goliath, were able to kill 200 Philistines alone. Today he just pretending like a madman, running from cave to cave, traversing wilderness. He has become a forlorn. Why has that happened? In that situation, at that time, against that background, he says, I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. The background is very, very important. In verse 2, my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. So when the psalmist says, the humble shall hear how I praise the Lord, how my soul boasts of the Lord. The humble shall hear that. Who are that humble? 1 Samuel 22 verse 2. 1 Samuel 22 verse 2. And everyone that was in distress, when David was in the cave of Adullam, some people joined him. Everyone that was in distress, and everyone that was in debt, and everyone that was discontented. I love you to note that word, everyone. Everyone who is in debt, who is unable to pay back the debt. The creditors have come to take them as slaves. They are unable to live in their society. They are unable to live in their country. The debtor, the creditors have come to take them into slavery, bond labor. They came running into this wilderness. Not only those who were in debt, they were in distress. They were pressed on all sides. They were in distress. And everyone that was discontented, they joined David. About 400 people. Just imagine, David is already running for his life. He calls him, I'm a dead dog. I'm a flea. And 400 men join this dead dog. How are they? Debtors, discontented, murmurers, those who cannot live in the society. If I put it in an ordinary, our expression, all velakanna munji, all 6 o'clock faces, running from their family, running from their society, trying to protect their life. That was the band with David. No one was cheerful. No one was happy. Everybody had their problems. My dear brother, my dear sister, when we are in problem, morning one phone comes with problem, 10 o'clock another phone comes with problem, 11 o'clock one family comes with problem, we become more broken. Then 3 o'clock another news. At times we love to sing like Podumada Sami. My dear brother, my dear sister, just imagine, not one person, 2 person, 400 people join David. All will be murmuring, blah, 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 blah. This is what my wife did, this is what my friend did, this is what my father did, this is the debt I am unable to pay. I don't know what happened to my mother, wife, I don't know what happened to our children. Murmuring. David was sitting in their midst and saying, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, hallelujah, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. They all were complaining and murmuring. David has got his own headache. But in that situation, David is saying, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. So here we read beautifully. And the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. So David, when they come and say, this is what happened, then David says, what you are saying? This greater thing has happened for me. I left my wife, I left my family, I left my father, I left my mother, I left my house, I came running to save my life. David was not complaining, David was not murmuring, David was not sharing his difficult situations. David started praising the Lord. Those who heard this, these murmurers, these distressed people, those who are in debt, everyone, they heard that and they are happy. And he tells them, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Don't go on telling me your stories. Magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. So these 400 men with David, he says, we will exalt the Lord together. Stop talking about all your blah, 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 blah crying stories. All crying babies. Now we will exalt the Lord together. And he tells them, see, I am also in this type of difficult situations. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. from all my fears. Number one, all fears. Just praise the Lord, whatever your situation may be, whatever the difficult path you are going through may be, just praise the Lord. And I want to know what we mean by fear. Fear, 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 we all talk about in a more scientific way. I want to know what fear is. Fear is instinctual response to potential danger. It's our instinct. It's our nature. It is an instinctual response to potential danger. There could be a danger. We are very certain there can be a danger. When there is a potential danger, an instinctual response is called fear. Different types of fear are there. One fear is future. We fear about future. We know what we are going to do in the future. And number fear is darkness. When there is dark, all of a sudden the light is on, off. There is a potential danger. You may knock over a furniture, or you may push a vase, or somebody may creep in, or you may not know where there is a snake or a serpent. It's not necessary to be there, or there can be an evil spirit. You see a potential danger. So your natural instinctual response is called fear. You fear this because of darkness. Death. You don't know what happened after death. You hear sermon after sermon about heaven and hell. You get a mental picture. You know that you'll go to heaven. But if I miss heaven, where will I go? You have fear about death. What will happen after death? Or somebody will think, will I be born like a monkey? Or will I be born like a crocodile or lizard? What will happen to me? Will my spirit be wandering? We don't know, it's in dark. So there is a fear of death and fear of uncertainties. We know how this end will be. Will it go smoothly or not? We are not very certain about the ends and the different types of fear. And another fear is fear of failure. Some people have a type of a fear for exam. The fear to go to a doctor. What would be the result? What will the doctor say? They don't want to test their diabetes level, their sugar level. They got a fear. They don't want to test their physical condition out of fear. Somebody, if he could cough, he'll have fear. Oh, I got cancer. If there is a panting, oh, I got cancer. I don't want to go to doctor. Doctor may say, I got cancer. Fear. That's why they don't want to take examinations. I don't know what the result would be. Why do you have exam fear? Exam fright? Why do we have exam fright? Because the result. We got fear for so many things. How to face tomorrow? The fear. How to bring up our girls? How to bring up our boys? When you hear this TV news, what will happen tomorrow? My dear brother, my dear sister, every parent will have this fear, a potential danger. There's a possibility for danger. My dear brother, my dear sister, it was the day that Hepsi was born, May 20. I saw the baby, the hospital prayed. There was an important program in the school, that holiday, but there was something that I have to make arrangement. I was to meet Sister Josephus at Church Park. So from the hospital, I rushed to Mount Road. There is a small dhaba, Punjab dhaba, just opposite to Church Park. I went there, I think that just to have some juice or something. I saw 5 children. 3 boys from Don Bosco. 2 girls from Church Park. They were in their uniform. The same dhaba. They were sitting in an unacceptable posture. Tears were rolling down in my eyes. The parents might be thinking, their sons, their daughters in the school, they all must be in standard 10, 11, 12. Very obscene posture they are sitting in that dhaba publicly. 3 boys, 2 girls from Don Bosco Church Park, very rich, affluent. The Lord has given a newborn baby, a girl baby in our hands. The Lord answered our tears. The Lord was able to protect our daughter. It's a responsibility of every parent, our holy fear. It's not out of unbelief. It's out of asking for God's mercies. My dear brother, my dear sister. So he says, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all fears. What are the different fears David had? What will happen tomorrow? Can he go back to his land? Can he see his parents anytime again? Can he have a normal life? He had many fears. He says all fears. So those debtors had some fears. Those who were in distress, they had fears. Those who were discontented, they had fears. So God delivered them from all their fears. They looked unto the Lord and their faces were lightened. Their faces were shining. My dear brother, my dear sister, God is able to deliver you, deliver us from all fears. So what are the symptoms of fear? A psychologist has recorded. I just show you those 6 things. Number one, your heart rate will speed up. Rapid heart rate. Number two, it is increased blood pressure. Fear will increase your blood pressure. Because there is an increased blood pressure and heart rate, your muscles will get tightened. That's why when you are at the dentist's chair, before he could extract, he'll say, be relaxed, be relaxed. When you are afraid, your muscles will get tightened and your senses will be sharpened. Your eyes will be dilated because you need more light. Your eyes will be dilated and you'll have increased sweating. Padatam. Palpitation. Nerves weakness. All because fears. Whatever your situation may be, the Lord is able to deliver you from all your situations. Worship the Lord. The great antidote, praise God at all times. Whatever the time of fear may be, the cause for fear may be, praise God at all times. He will deliver you from all your fears. My dear brother, my dear sister. Number 2, verse 6. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all troubles. This all troubles, that word is all tightness, all tight situations. In Tamil we use, there you see the word, idukkan, irukkamana vali. That is the valley through which David was walking. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that valley is not something like a Kashmir valley. It's not a green meadow. What David said, I walked through the valley of the shadow of death. It was something like a gorge, a very narrow, risky, rocky path between two rocks. It's very dark. There's no light inside. To the left, rugged rock. To the right, rugged rock. Rocks underneath. Maybe a forest water, a stream. Slippery. You have to walk. That is the idukan. There's no other way. You have to walk. It's between the devil and the deep sea. You have to cross through. Irukkamana paadai. You can't relax. You can't just wait there. You have to walk through. That's the word used here. Idukkan. The tight situation. Sometimes financially very tight. We have to pay the fees. We have to pay the rent. We have to pay the EMI. That's the time that the child says, I have to pay this for the excursion. Even basic fees you are unable to pay. The child wants some money for excursion or for a project or for a field trip. You are in a tight situation financially. This is the resource. 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. But I have to feed more than 5,000 mouths. With this, what can I do? With this, what can I do? Even how much I plan. Very tight, straight situation. There is no flexibility. I cannot plan anything. Are you going through that tight situation? Can you praise God at that situation? It may be a financial tight situation. There is another tight situation. In psychology we say relationship tightness. We got people all around, but we could not free with anybody. That's another tight situation. You can't talk to your husband freely. You can't talk to your wife freely. You can't express your feelings to your father freely. The parents don't understand. Whatever the situation may be, that girl Vinupriya went into a very tight relationship situation. Her parents could not help her. Police could not help her. They all are around her. They could not see the situation seriously. Now father, mother, to whom she can depend on? She was in a tight situation. In the office, nobody talks to me. Manager doesn't talk to me. My friends, they don't talk to me. Those who are subordinates, they don't talk to me. A tight situation, there's nobody. With the neighbors, a tight situation. Not very free. When you go out, you can't just tell your neighbor, have a look at our house. Have take care of our child. You don't have a neighbor like that. You don't have a relationship with a neighbor. When you go out in our old days, you lock the door, give the key to the neighbor, and wait to get around the savi kuduthirunga. There will be only one key. They'll easily give to the neighbor and go. 30 days they'll give the key to the neighbor and go to their native place. Today they are unable to do. The neighbor is not willing to receive the key. We don't have a relationship with the neighbors. Financial tightness, relationship tightness, work situation tightness. Tight work. No breather. Getting at 4 o'clock, no time for prayer. Work, 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 work. Then run to the office. Work, 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 work. Run back to home. Work, 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 work. Oh, I don't have a situation to relax. We go through tightness. Here he says there's trouble. He talks about a tight situation. Not only he delivers us from all fears, he delivers us, saves us from all our tight situations. Keep the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes in the presence of God and start praising God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Oh, will miracle take place? Yes, miracle will take place. He'll tell us what we should do. So here he says, the poor man cried and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his tight situations. That is all number 2. All fears, all tightness. Number three that we read in verse 17. The righteous cry. The poor man cried, I sought the Lord. The righteous cried, and the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The same word is used here. In Tamil, for verse 6 it is said idukan, and in verse 17 it said ubatrava. 2 different words are used. One is a very straight situation, a very gorgeous situation. The other one is a literally troubled situation that could trouble us. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Maybe all these things may seem to be similar, but slightly different. Certain fears trouble us. Certain tight situations trouble us. We lose our peace of mind. We lose joy. Our prayer life has become a victim. They are the troubled situations. In a very simpler way for you to understand trouble, I give this statement. I had trouble finding somewhere to park. I had trouble. In Tamil we can say kashtam. I have to park my vehicle. It may seem to be very simple. But you know, I have to go and buy something. Parking lot is full. I can't leave the vehicle on the road. I have to park it. There is no parking place. But I have to go to that medical shop. I have to buy that medicine. There is no parking place. I can't leave the vehicle. Trouble. This is trouble. I don't know what to do. It's not that a tight situation, there's a lot of space, water, everywhere water, but there's not a drop to drink. A lot of space, but there's no space to park the vehicle. What is a problem or a trouble? Problems, difficulties, some issues. It's a trouble. I'm preparing for this morning message. A pastor who loves me very much, always he comes to me for my help. Like our own son, we love them very much. He phones and there's a problem in his church. It's an issue that troubles me. There's an issue that troubles me. Somebody is threatened with a police case. There's an issue that troubles me. So a problem, a difficulty, an issue, something that bothers you, something that causes inconvenience, worry, anxiety, distress, depression. You're concerned. You're concerned about your daughter. You're concerned about that marriage. You're concerned about that financial problem. You're concerned. You are disquieted, unease, irritated. Your vexation, annoyance, stress, agitated, harassment, unpleasantness, all these things will connect you a trouble. So here he says, the righteous cried and the Lord heard. You cry, the Lord will hear and deliver you out of your, all your troubles, all fears, all tightness, all troubles, problems, issues. All number four, all types of fears, all types of troubles. Verse 19, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth them, delivereth him out of them all afflictions. You know the affliction for me yesterday? Everything seemed to be the same. I was afflicted to find the difference. That's one affliction, one trouble. Fear? I want a lot. Easy to say fear. But what is that fear? Trouble. Why two places it is said trouble? And Tamil, they got two different meanings. One is idukan, one is ubadram. Then what is the Hebrew says? Oh, that is tightness. What is tightness? Then what are the psychology says about tightness? Then what are the troubles? How do I understand trouble from the dictionary? Then what is the affliction? Affliction is because something bad, evil or adverse happened. We are afflicted. We are troubled because we don't have a parking place, but I have to park there, leave the vehicle, I have to get a medicine, I am troubled. I am anxious, I am concerned. There is an issue. I have to immediately address that. One of my friends phones and says, hey, there is an accident, come rushing. It troubles me, I am concerned. It is not actually I am in a tight situation. Your daughter phones or your son phones, caught in a problem. You can't do anything, but you are troubled. But affliction is something because bad happens. Something because adverse happened. Maybe because of a loss. Maybe because of death. Maybe because of sickness. Maybe because some opposition in the work spot, relatives, in the family. You're afflicted because of misunderstanding. Nobody understands you. Maybe because of accidents. Or maybe you're afflicted because of demonic oppressions. This is your afflictions. So, what are the way you are afflicted with? God is able to deliver you. In all this, all he says, God saves, God delivers. From all fears, God delivered. From all straight situations, tightness, God delivered. From all types of troubles, problems, issues, God will deliver. Here he says, from all type of bad things, evil things, adverse things which happen in our lives, God will deliver. And the fifth one that we read in verse 20, he keepeth all his bones, not one of them is broken. He keeps all our bones. Not one bone will be broken. This prophecy was historically proven in the life of Jesus in his death. But what does it actually mean to us? In the Bible, bone speaks about two things. Bone speaks about hope. Our hopes dry, our bones dry. Bone speaks about hope. Number two, bone speaks about the structure. We have got the structure. The structure is because of a orthosystem, a bone system inside. If the bone system is not there, we may not have a structure, we'll just collapse. And these bones only give us mobility. So all our bones are not broken. None of your hope will be broken. None of your mobility will be broken. None of the structure will be disturbed. None of your bone will be broken. Samuel came and anointed David and said that he will become the king. David hoped that. Things are not moving in that direction. But David is in the wilderness. But David believed, my hopes will not be broken. My bone will not be broken. My mobility will not be broken. The Death pangs may be close by me. I may be walking through the valley of the shadow of death. I fear no evil. No evil will take place. None of my bones will be broken. God is there. God will take care of it. My dear brother, my dear sister, all fears, all straight situations, all problems, and all afflictions, all bad things, evil things, adverse things, all hopes, nothing will happen. That's why he says, at all times I bless the Lord. Where there is a situation to fear, or there is a situation I have to walk, I have to have a tightrope walk, or there is a situation where my mind is troubled, or there is an affliction around me, where my hope is questioned, God will deliver me. So I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will be continually in my mouth. My dear brother, my dear sister, what should we do for this? What should we do for this deliverance? Or to have this frame of mind, to experience this. I sought the Lord and he heard me. Still he is in the cave of Adullam. Still he is in the cave of Adullam. But his confidence level was so high. I sought the Lord and he heard me. He will deliver me. My dear brother, my dear sister. Just from Psalm 34, I give you 20 points. Have a pen and pencil, your paper ready to jot down these 20 points. What did psalmist do to have this frame of mind? This moral strength, spiritual strength, psychological strength. Let come what may. I will bless the Lord at all times. 20 things I say quickly, make a note very fast. Number 1, verse 34, verse 1. Two things. I will bless the Lord at all times. Number 2, his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Stotram, 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 stotram. It's not just repetition. Feeling sincerely, praising the Lord. His praise shall be continually in my, Lord, you will not forsake me, stotram. Lord, your mercy endureth forever. Stotra under, praise you, Lord, praise you, Lord. It should be continually in my mouth. Verse 2, number 3. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. I am in the Lord. I am saved. I am in Christ. I got a covenant relationship with the Lord. Oh my soul, why are you disquieted within me? Oh my soul, why are you troubled? My soul, thank God. Bless the Lord, my soul, bless the Lord. Bless his name. Your soul must boast in the Lord. Verse 3. Number 4. Magnify the Lord. Speak high about the Lord. Then sings my soul. How great thou art. Lord, you are able to make a way in the wilderness. Lord, you are able to make a way in the sea. Lord, you are able to make a way in the river Jordan. Lord, you are able to make the fort of Jericho fall. Lord, you are a great God. Then sings my soul. How great thou art. Magnify the Lord. Verse 5. Exalt his name. Lord, your name is great. Yeah, Yahweh Yireh, you shall see, it shall be seen, you shall see to it, O Allah. You are Jehovah Nissi, Yahweh Nissi, you are the banner of my victory, you are Yahweh Shama, you are with me, O Allah, you are Yahweh Shalom, you are my peace, O Master God, exalt his name. Number 6, in verse 4, in verse 10, seek the Lord, praise the Lord, exalt the Lord, magnify the Lord. Seek the Lord. Before seeking man, before running to your mother, before running to your father, before running to your friend, before running to your doctor, seek the Lord. Seek his presence. Seek his counsel. Number 7, that in verse 5, look unto him. Look unto him. Praise him. Exalt him. Magnify him. Let your psyche, your soul, boast in the Lord. Seek the Lord. Number 7, look unto the Lord. Number 8, cry unto the Lord. Verse 6, cry unto the Lord. Pour your heart unto the Lord. Pray. Jesus cried with a loud voice. verses 7, 9 and 11. Point number 9, fear him. Fear him. Grace gives us fear to the Lord. Fear to fear the Lord. What will God say? Can I do this? Will this please God? So number 9, fear the Lord. Allow that you take down all these points. Your psyche will change. You'll have moral strength, physical strength, spiritual strength, emotional strength. Fear the Lord. Verse 8. Taste and see the Lord is good. Think about the past experiences. Meditate on the testimonies you have heard. Taste and see the Lord is good. And number 11, trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. More than trust in your money. More than trust in the horses. More than trust in the chariots. More than trust in your muscle power. More than trust in the manpower. Trust in the Lord. Verse 13, the 12th point. Keep thy tongue from evil. In all your fears, in all your difficult situations, when you are fighting against hope, keep your tongue from evil. Don't speak words of unbelief. Under Kaivutta. What can God do? God can help only those who help themselves. Even God cannot help me. Don't speak words of evil. They are bad words. That will spoil your faith. That will spoil your blessing. So number 12. Keep thy tongue from evil. Keep thy tongue from evil. Number 13. Lives from speaking guile. Lives from speaking guile. 14. Depart from evil. These two things. God cannot come to help you. There is guile in you. And you are doing evil things. So God is unable to help you. In other words, 15, do good. 16, seek peace. 17, pursue it. Do good, seek peace, pursue it. These 5 points is a separate message. Depart from evil. Depart from evil. And depart from guile. Do good, seek peace, pursue it. Why? You create an atmosphere around you for God to help you. Don't create an atmosphere around you where God can't help you. You are murmuring, you are complaining, you are fighting against your husband, you are fighting against your parents, you are blaming everybody, you are blaming God. You are creating a situation where God cannot help you. It's a very powerful message for you this morning. For God to help you, create a situation and atmosphere around you. Do good. Seek peace. Pursue it. You're creating a situation where God is able to help you. There are a number of verses I can show to you from the scripture. Especially in the Old Testament. If I see this in you, I will depart from you. If I see this in you, I will depart from you. If I see this in you, I will depart from you. The Lord will not be with you. And there's darkness, the light cannot be there. So create a situation around you where the Lord could bless you. So praise God all times. Bless the Lord and magnify His name, magnify Him, exalt Him, speak boast of Him. How great you exalt His name, that great you can see a miracle. Don't exalt your problem. Let your soul sing, how great thou art. I need 2,000 rupees. Lord, how great thou art. I need 20,000 rupees. It's a must. I'm going through a very strait situation. Lord, how great thou art. You are greater than the 20,000. You are greater than the 2 lakhs. How great thou art. Elisha, the Syrian army, their horses, horsemen, chariots, they have encompassed about you. Lord, how great thou art. You are greater than the Syrian army. One who is with me is greater than one who is with the world. How great you are. Exalt his name. Headache. Lord is greater than headache. Stomachache. God is greater than stomachache. Eosinophilia. God is greater than eosinophilia. Cancer. God is greater than cancer. AIDS. My God is greater than AIDS. Exalt his name. Then sings my soul. How great thou art. Headache. God will heal me. Cancer. Only doctor can heal me. AIDS. Nobody can heal. You are limiting God. His name is above all names. Exalt his name. His name is above headache. His name is above cancer. His name is above AIDS. Above every situation that troubles our mind. So exalt him. Cry unto him. Trust him. Taste and see that the Lord is good. He'll deliver you from all fears. He will deliver you from all afflictions. He will deliver you from all tight situations. Number 18. We read in verse 15, 17 and 19. Point number 18. Be righteous. Do the right thing. This righteousness is not just a moral righteousness. That's very essential. And spiritually, philosophically, righteousness is right standing with God. What is right for God is right for me. What God wants me to do, I do. God wants me to be a pastor, I want to be a pastor. Certainly, to be a pastor is not the cup of, it's not my cup. Even in my dream, I never desired this. It's God's plan for me. What is right with God is right with me. My dear brother, my dear sister, every situation will have its own problem. The other day I was grumbling in my weakness. Yo, what a big problem just to be a pastor. If I come, I have to worry about the generator, then about the plumbing, about the PA system, about some families, about some uncleanness, about somebody sick. Evangelist, no responsibility, going from place to place, speak. The Lord has given me talent, the Lord has given me wisdom, the Lord has given me gift, the Lord has given me everything. But that's not the will of God concerning me. That's not the will of God concerning me. What is righteousness? Right standing with God. What is right for God is right for me. So number 18 is very, very important. Your righteousness. Your right standing with God. My dear brother, my dear sister. Number 19. Who can see these miracles? Deliverance in difficult situations. Deliverance from fears. How can I experience that deliverance? That anxiety, that affliction, where I'm fighting for hopes. I don't know how to move, how to take the next step. I think that all my hopes are shattered. My bones have become dry, scattered, strewn all over. No hope that it can be united. All scattered bones, dry bones, very dry. My dear brother, my dear sister, how is it possible? Then you are with a broken heart and a contrite spirit. That broken is not because of affliction. That broken is not because of your troubles broken because of love of God. Lord, without you I can do nothing, Lord. I can do nothing. Father God, unless you help me, I cannot move forward. A broken heart, I can manage. No problem. Somehow I manage. God is unable to help you. You are unable to find your deliverance. I cannot do anything without God. On the other side, I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me. I can do nothing without Him. I can do all things with Him. That broken heart, poor in the spirit. Blessed are they that are poor in the, not arrogant. What daddy? What mommy? I can manage. When you think that you can manage, God will not help. My dear brother, my dear sister, for the glory of the Lord I say, till this day, more than 1,000 sermons I would have preached. 73 January I started preaching. More than 43 years I am preaching. Even minimum 50 sermons a year, easily 2,000. All humility I tell. Till yesterday, it's a fear. What I'm going to do? What I'm going to do? What I'm going to do? How will I preach? Some people, I heard one of our brothers many times told me about somebody else. 5 minutes, I can prepare a sermon. I'm unable to do it. God has not forsaken. But that broke, Lord, what I'll do? What I'll do? What I'll do? It's not a fear of unbelief. It's a fear of my weakness. I know God has not forsaken me. He will not forsake. It's not something to think I can do it. Somehow I can manage. Till this morning I'm not standing here with that confidence that I could manage. My dear brother, my dear sister, a broken heart and a contrite spirit. The Lord will deliver you from all troubles, all afflictions, all fears, all tight situations, if you have a broken heart and a contrite spirit. And number 20, very important one, as the phrase goes, last not but the least, but I can say the best. We see in verse 20, verse 22, be his servant. He will deliver you. He will deliver the soul of his servant. Be the servant of God. It's not a question of a part-time or a full-time. In one way or the other, have a desire to serve the Lord. 1 week has passed by. If I ask you to stand up and say, through the past 1 week, those who serve the Lord, sit. I don't know how many of us could sit. My dear brother, my dear sister, before I came for the full-time ministry, in Christ my soul can boast, I serve the Lord more. I serve the Lord more. I talk to my students about the Lord. I talk to my friends about the Lord. I talk to my colleagues about the Lord. I serve them. Through my life, through a booklet, through a testimony, somehow or the other, I serve the Lord. Not only to my students, my teachers, to my colleagues, tirelessly, I serve the Lord. Every evening, Almost I'd be going somewhere to preach the word of God. I was a teacher, teaching in a private school. I had to prepare my lessons. I received Best Teacher Award. I don't imagine I ever entered the class without taking a teaching aids with me. There was never a complaint that I have never failed to correct my students' notebooks or exam papers. I had my own duty. Today many people, they got a type of a lust for rest, a lust for comforts, which I never heard. As a challenge, I tell you, if you want to experience this deliverance from your fears, from your troubles, you want to have this frame of mind, you must serve the Lord. You must serve the Lord. I cannot imagine one evening with all my studies when I was in my B.Ed. college. I did my internship course. I did my AIDS projects, writing the lesson plans, coming first in the college. In my practicals, first in the college. Every evening serving the Lord. If anybody says you don't have time, I say either you lust for comfort or you are a liar. My dear brother, my dear sister, I served the Lord in the train. I was staying at Tirunindavu. My college was at Rayapeta. Every day I travel from Tirunindavu to Central Station, from Central Station to Rayapeta, I serve the Lord. What about my studies? I studied well. And I became a teacher. I serve the Lord. It's not to speak about I want to tell you that it's possible. A number of occasions, one occasion I tell you, when I was in SBOE, I was to preach, I was to take a Bible study. Even in those days I used to take Bible study. I had to prepare for the Bible study, I had to prepare for the lesson, I had to teach in the class. My dear brother, my dear sister, at times there will be 6 periods out of 8. I have to teach. Remaining 2 periods, I have to correct the notebooks. As soon as the class is over, I had to go for the Bible study. That day, there's no petrol in my bike. I had a beautiful bike. I pushed that bike more than I drew on that bike. There was no petrol. I ran to one of my friend's house. He has got a bicycle. He was not in the house. He has taken the cycle and gone. From Annanagar to Coimbatore. Literally, I was a teacher in the local area. Carrying my Bible. It was time up. I was running. Literally I was running on the road. A father of 2 children. A senior staff in that area. I served my God. I am proud of it. You want to lie down. You want to have time for your own comforts. How can the Lord bless you? We envy at the people those who are blessed. My dear brother, my dear sister. Literally I ran on the road because I want to take the Bible study. May, everybody would be enjoying their holidays, going out as a family. I don't know whether I was right or wrong, but today I enjoy God's blessings. Since we got married, nearly 4 years I think, not once I was with my wife on the day of marriage. Today everybody is celebrating wedding anniversary. We never knew that. I praise God for the grace given to sister also. Every May I go out on my preaching assignments. Today wedding day, they all want to celebrate. Our celebration was ministry. There was no phone. I cannot even say hello. Many happy returns of the day. I cannot tell my wife that. She cannot phone and talk to me. I was 25, she was 23. I go back the memory lane and see how people very easily take the ministry today. My dear brother, my dear sister. I used to carry two bags. One with my clothes, two boxes. One box with all my... I never thought that I should all say these things. You don't have an excuse. One bag, one box full of papers. Full of papers. God is a witness. We ask Brother James, he will give a witness for this. Many times he helped me in totaling my answer papers when we were in the meeting. In Kanyakumari, morning 10 o'clock Bible study, that will go up to 1 o'clock. Then 3 o'clock, Abhishega Kutam, that will go up to 5 o'clock. Then 7 o'clock, evening convention meeting, that will go up to 10 o'clock. You have to preach for at least 3 hours without any story. Otherwise your rating will go in Kanyakumari. They all love the word of God like that. 10 o'clock, squeezed out. Morning 10 to 1, 3 hours Bible study. 3 to 5, 2 hours anointing meeting. Evening 7 to 10, again preaching in the convention. Squeezed out. Come home around 11 o'clock, 11 to 1 in the night, correcting the papers. Not 1 year, not 2 years, almost till I could come out of the job. Every May I go out. Maybe one or two occasions in May I might have been in the house. To think of my wife's, our wedding day, or to think of our daughter's birthday. That's also in May. If you want to enjoy all these blessings, in one way or the other, serve the Lord. For some people, if they come in the morning, they cannot come in the evening. They can't come for the Bible study. Oh, we are tired. There was not one Sunday evening when I was studying or working that I was lying down in the house. My dear brother, my dear sister, serving the Lord. So in verse 22 we read, God will deliver his servants. God will deliver the soul of his servant. He will surely show a difference between they that serve him and they don't serve him. Those who love ministry and those who lust comforts. Those who love ministry and those who lust comforts. Many times I remember in my crusades, even in those days, many times I thought, that's the last time I'm preaching. I will die before I could finish this sermon. I will give my lungs out. I will shout. I don't know why. I will shout. I'll pray for hundreds of people, those who come for prayer. I pray the deliverance prayer. I'll be thinking, Lord, now I may swoon and fall down. I may faint. Lord, have me, give me the pleasure that I die when I'm ministering to you. I lusted it. God willing, he would give that to me. God willing, he would give that to me. This time when I went to Coimbatore, there's nobody to accompany me. I'm reading the scriptures about Paul, about Peter. The Bible says in many places, they accompanied Paul. They went with Paul. In Tamil, there is a beautiful expression again and again. Avanukku valithunaiyai ponargal. Valithunaiyai ponargal. There was nobody with me for my valithunai. There's nobody with me for my valithunai. There's nobody with me to help me in my ministry. I was left alone. My dear brother, my dear sister, I tell you, when I was in Coimbatore, it's the first time I have been there. They don't know the family, they don't know anybody's address here. They know only my phone number. If something happens to me, even it will be very difficult for them to contact anybody here. I risked my life. Why I say this? My dear brother, my dear sister, serve the Lord in one way or the other. You shall have all these blessings. He will deliver you from all fears, from all tightness, from all troubles, from all afflictions, from all situations where you cannot hope. You will save all your bones. When He does all these things, at all times, you will be able to bless the Lord. There will be praises continually in your lips. Whether there's a situation to fear, whether it was an affliction, bad things are happening, whether there is a sickness or it's trouble or tightness, whatever it may be, you can bless the Lord all times. His praise will be continually in your mouth. 18 things I told you, 20 things I told you. How you can develop this spiritual mental caliber. Bless Him at all times. Let His praise continually be in your lips. Exalt His name. Don't magnify your problem. Magnify the Lord. Magnify the Lord. Don't magnify your problem. Don't magnify a problem out of proportion. He is great. Seek the Lord. Cry unto Him. Taste and see the Lord is good. Trust the Lord. Trust the Lord always. Speak to others about this God. Let the people see that you are praising God. Create a situation around you where the Lord could help you. Refrain your tongue from speaking bad things, evil things, things of unbelief. Do good. Seek peace. Pursue peace. Be righteous. Be righteous above all. In season, out of season. Whether there is time or no time. Whether there is time or no time. Serve the Lord. Seek the Lord. Increase your spiritual strength. Attending prayer meetings. Attending group meetings. Attending sisters' prayer meeting. Serving the Lord. Going for a Bible study. Reading. Increase your strength. Today I am what I am. I don't say I am the perfect example. The other day I was telling somebody, when I think about the saints of the past, when they are mountains, when they are Himalayas, I'm only a pebble. I'm only a pebble. But I'm worried, some of you are not even a sand. Some of you are not even a sand. My dear brother, my dear sister. The other day I asked somebody, why so-and-so is not doing this? Oh, very tight work. In the school, private school. I loved. I also worked in a private school. I was the best teacher. I was not. I didn't have a complaint against me. In the presence of God, I tell you, there was not even one day a complaint that I didn't correct my notebooks. I didn't do my classwork properly. My dear brother, my dear sister, my student is sitting here. He is a testimony that ever any time that I have been slothful in my work. Probably I might have overworked. Serve the Lord. Then, very boldly you can say, I will bless the Lord at all times. And continually, His praise shall be in my mouth. You will develop a spiritual life. That you can always say, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. He will deliver you from all fears, from all tight situations, from all troubles, from all situations where your hopes are questioned. Shall we stand to our feet? Today take a decision. I'm not going to magnify my problems. I'm not going to exalt my weaknesses. A broken spirit, a contrite, a broken heart, a contrite spirit. Without the Lord, I can't do anything. With the Lord, I can do everything. Hallelujah. Be righteous in your lifestyle. And above all, try to serve the Lord. Surely He will show a difference between them that serve Him and those who don't serve Him. You serve the Lord in one way or the other. After all, one day we are going to die. Don't lust for comfort. Don't lust for rest. Even a few days back, I told somebody, he asked me, you want to take rest? I said, the days of rest is yet to come. The days of rest is yet to come. These are not the days to rest. Nowadays you don't try to rest. Don't try to rest. I want to lie down for some time. I have cautioned you. You desire lying down. The Lord grants the desire of your heart. It will become miserable. Even when you cannot walk with the men, how will you run with horses? How will you run with horses? If at all you die, die when you are serving the Lord, then dying on your bed without serving the Lord. I don't say death should not come in sleep. I'm not talking about that. The Spirit of the Lord is talking to you. It's a wonderful blessing. Bless the Lord at all times. Let His praise be continually in our mouth. Shall we pray?